What is best in life? Due to some recording difficulties, there is a lost section of Zoroastrian Restoration this week. What did happen, though, in the portion of the tape that was lost, was the Caliph again broke what I thought was our peace pact, and declared war upon me again. He arrested me. He won the war, arrested me, and then deposited me in jail, but then he released me without stripping me of any of my titles. I then declined to take part in a generalized uprising against the Caliph. I refused to join the uprising. And immediately after that, the Caliph sent me a demand that I give up the Sultanate of Quivir. I rejected the demand to fight a battle again, and here I am fighting. I was hoping that I would be able to join a generalized uprising against the Caliph, but that option was no longer on the table, and I'm now fighting my second uprising against the Caliph alone, and it's not going very well. It's just an inevitable defeat. I tried Tainted Touch on the Caliph and did not kill him, and it appears I cannot try Tainted Touch again. I was appointed the High Priest of Lucifer's Own, not that that's doing me too much good. And so here I am. I am fighting this war, the second war that the Caliph has declared on me. He can command 14,000 troops, and I can command 3,000 troops. And that includes having spent a large chunk of my money on mercenaries that have been proving rather ineffectual. And so that is where the war stands at this moment. There are large groups of troops over here in my territory. I am winning some minor victories against their secondary groups. And I guess all we can do is fight out this war and see where it takes us and see how many of my titles I lose at the end of this war. I should pick a focus for my character. I guess war is not really going to win this for me. If I take an intrigue focus, that will increase my plot power. I am plotting to kill the Caliph. I only have 89% plot power, so we'll get that started. And we'll see what I can do with my army. I'm trying to hit the smaller units of soldiers before they unite into larger units, but I can only do that for so long. And I watch from the shadows as my spymaster, Mayor Murad, surreptitiously marked a spot on the wall with a piece of chalk. This might just be his normal skullduggery, but my intuition says not. Time to spy on the spy. He hates me. My own spymaster hates me. Time to spy on the spy. But I don't have anyone who likes me anymore in the entire kingdom. Hamden, my wife. My wife hates me, although she hates me less than others. Over the week, I've observed my spymaster. Actually, I will demonic possession and try to possess him by a demon. Morad has found nothing further to arouse my suspicions. Perhaps he'll just have to accept that odd behavior goes with the job. I have more important things to do, but I am going to try to possess him with a demon, and that should keep him on my side. In the middle of the night, I seclude myself in a room I have meticulously prepared for tonight's magic. With every step of the ritual completed, the air in the room grows more and more oppressing until finally I sense I am about to unleash a being of terrible power upon my unsuspecting foe. Do it, and I will try to take possession. Oh, and 3,000 troops just joined this army, and this is the end of any sort of meaningful resistance, I think, that I can offer. They're doing a pretty game job, but they're outnumbered by 1,000 still. So they're just going down for the count. I only lost a couple hundred more than they did. The ritual was a resounding success. He seems to be quite obviously insane, but he is possessed by a demon. But even possessed by a demon, he still has a negative 78% opinion of me, even though he's a loyal servant. And that's because my raised levies penalty is too strong. And there are 4,000 here, 1,000 here. I have 1,800 troops. He won't even accept enforced title revocation is allowed. Lethal nightmares? No. My son? They tried to kill my son? My demon child is killing my entire family. And now they've tried to kill my one adult son that I need to stay alive. Because he's, well, he doesn't have very good stats, but they're better than most of my family. And, oh. And he's a Zoroastrian. He's a Marsden, though, actually. Yes, let's get this marriage going. Sure, I'll torture a prisoner, why not? And I'll see if I can snag this group of 500, but he's between two armies of a couple of thousand. After a lengthy discussion about the logistics of an upcoming ritual, my brother in darkness, Mayor Marco of Pleven, stood up and abruptly, a depraved grin splitting his face, said, "Well, I'm bored. Let's head down to the town and have some fun with the peasants. About time, I'll bring my favorite garrote." Wearing nondescript clothes, Marco and I are slowly making our way to town in amiable silence. As we pass by a neatly kept garden in front of a cozy-looking house, I am suddenly overcome with hatred and revulsion. This family is clearly favored by Ormazd. It's time to do Ahriman's work. The father of the family died last. Finally, we constructed an idol of Turaz from the dismembered bodies. Burn it all, no more must know. Leaving it would please Ahriman more. I'll gain 200 dark power and a blessing. So there's a peasant revolt against me. Predictably, the populace of Gurgan didn't appreciate the glorious monument of tortured flesh that was left for them to find. In fact, they were so riled up that they've taken up arms against their rightful rulers. Peasants have risen up in Gurgan, led by a disgruntled former soldier. The rebels have the nerve to demand independence. I have a feeling they'll be put down by the... Oh, that's the Gurgan peasant revolt. Spawn of Angra Manu. My daughter Jamila has always been a strange one, warring friends and relatives, as well as members of the clergy, with her acts of wanton cruelty, not to mention the creepy buzzing noises she makes, the birds falling dead from the sky, and all the little accidents happening around her. Despite all the best efforts at education from tutoring, our hopes have been dashed. A child no more, she has turned into a truly frightening young woman. She shall lead us to victory. And she's a demon spawn, my daughter. She likes me. The child of Satan, the day of reckoning is nigh, the daughter of Angra Manu, is finally loose in the world of men. Our new mistress will lead us to victory against the Lion Creator and all his weak minions. The brothers and sisters of Lucifer's Own will stand ready to support Jamila Alandandot in her relentless march towards Armageddon. My daughter, I am so proud. Now, can I marry her or something? Arrange marriage? I'll marry her off to Elb. And jeez, okay, so he's getting married to my cousin. Come on, Caliph, let's win this war and get it over with. It's hard to feel proud when one has nothing to be proud of. I lose the trait proud. Oh, is there no one in the Caliph? Who's the Caliph's hair? I'm afraid Gurgan is going to go independent on me because I am destroying myself in this war. I've got to go. I should steer clear. I can't stop her. No, okay, I'll torture more prisoners. Not that it's doing me any good. But I'll try to go get rid of these rebels in Gurgan. My Azbada Argba kindly suggested it would be of benefit to the realm if I studied the languages spoken at foreign courts. An excellent idea. It looks like I'm going to lose Gurgan and Quivir. I'm going to lose two of my trading posts on the Silk Road, which is disappointing. Somebody is trying to conspire to kill my son. I can't send him into hiding, though. Let's see if I can marry him off to anyone useful. Or anyone with good traits. Now there's a 29-year-old. Step joy in my heart and a smile on my face. I'm no longer stressed, even though my world is crumbling upon around me. Is my chancellor still trying to? Yeah, he's still in Dashistan and fabricate claims. Sure, I'll torture some prisoners. It seems to make me feel better. Defeat. 75% defeat. So I may be killing the Caliph, prove the plan. Hang in there, troops. Come on, you can't beat some peasants. Some ridiculous peasants. Darn it. So I haven't even been able to defeat the peasants, and I was hoping that the Sultan would actually go and defeat the peasants as well. But the Sultan's army seemed to have disappeared somewhere. Praise be, Armand, my black magic has borne fruit. News has reached me that the deceitful glutton, Prince Misra's recent illness, he is suffering from measles, and I doubt he will last long. There we go, I did the tainted touch. His health is -2. May demons dance upon Misra's grave. peasants' revolt has moved. Someone is trying to do a tainted touch on me. I'll do dark healing. Though I suffer for now no earthly ailments beyond the power of every man, I am preparing a great ritual to cleanse my body and become like new. It could be that I am using the powers of Lucifer's own too freely. People are becoming more suspicious. As the ritual is being finished, I can feel my strength returning to me, purging the weakness that has been holding my body in a vice. I lose the trait rash. There we go. So I've been healed. And actually, I will summon a familiar. Intrigue plus 3. And actually, that's what I'll do. I'll kill this guy. The leader of the peasants' revolt. Tainted touch him. People are becoming suspicious. I will also plot to kill. One of my commanders is improved. That's good. You're not winning any wars yet, though, I notice. I can't help but notice you're not winning any war. Intrigue. Doesn't look... Oh, it looks like my plot probably is failing. Oh, yes, I want to do this, but it'll just cost me gold, and then I'll lose it when I die. I just don't see me surviving to use it, so I'll let it go, unfortunately. And I'm gaining 135 soldiers a month, so I just need to wait a couple of months till I can catch up. My black magic is borne fruit, and this has reached me at the deceitful boar Perosa's recent illness. So is he going to die? He has a slow fever. And he's dead. And does that end the peasant revolt? No, someone took over the peasant revolt. It used to be if you killed the head of the peasant revolt. Someone has converted to... Oh, an army of 10,000 just attacked me. Just as I was about to take out the peasant revolt, and he's not taking, so I'm gonna lose both Gergan and Quivir, my two. I've learned a new language, that's great. I'm getting to be more diplomatic. That'll be useful in my jail cell. I should have attacked the peasant revolt when I had a chance. 97%, come on. Farad of the Gergan Peasant Revolt has usurped the title of Marzipan of Gergan, and I lost, so I have lost control of the Peasant Revolt of Gergan, capital. And I am jailed. I accept an offer of peace. And who's been my regent? A Wali, a Baron, is my regent. So, where will you proselytize? And he's revoked the Jaws Shoddom. I humbly accept your decision to revoke the Jaws Shoddom, though it grieves me deeply. So what territories do I have left? Amaristan Imrit, so I have all the Imrits, but not the Shadum. Disaster has been caught by the Court of Man and his warriors rots away. It's a sign for me to lay low. I revoke the Sheikdom of Kazwin. Is that all he's gonna take? And he's taking Alamut, all falsely confessed, secretly practicing the Zoroastrian religion. Oh, I can't even try to secretly practice Sunni Islam. He's going to torture me and release me. Revoke title. He has decided to immediately revoke the title of Sheikdom of Tabriz, fairly to hand it over to the war. I'll just accept. Back our plot to see. Sure, I'll back any plot. Why not? So I am down to the Emirate of Tabaristan. Transferred the vassalage of Sheikh Idris of Kazwin, so Kazwin is now my heir again, or is now, according to Grand Vizier Fazaz, the peasants of Kuvir have started a delightful tradition where the peasantry from several villages meet up and feast and pair up for future marriage. By promoting this tradition, Hafez believes the country will develop a strong local culture that will attract more peasants. I will support it. I have not called upon the powers of Lucifer's own for some time. So now the Emirate of Tabaristan. Sure, I'll torture more people. Sheikh of Kuvir, Emirate of Galan, Emirate of Tabaristan. And we have decided to immediately revoke your title as Jaws Emirate. So what titles do I have left? Emirate of Galan and Sheikh of Tabriz. And this is and Sheikdom I should have thought of this earlier, but I will. Give away. Against the Shah again. With seniority succession, who holds the titles to Dalem? It's the Caliph. So these titles are not coming back to my family. But my heir is There's a noble warrior at the gate. Welcome him. Taken over my titles, news from China, rumors of the military might of the Tang Empire. It's proving to be a forceful diplomatic tool in itself. High Chief Arzen of the Cleansing Flame has peacefully agreed to become a tributary state of the Middle Kingdom, so be it. Send some light cavalry. The Jaws Liberation Bolt. I have gained sympathy for his land. Troops can I raise? I can still raise. Where are the 1,835 that I hired? Oh, way over here. I still had an army, for Pete's sake. Songs of Anguish. My nights are plagued by terrible nightmares featuring the vile Petros, my rival brother in darkness. He howls and roars at me to the tune of infernal bagpipes while Sawar looks on. I will invite him over for some fun. And slay him recreationally. Yes, he is dead, and I gain 200 dark power. Now the peasant revolt. Oh, it's the Caliph that's putting down the peasant revolt, not me. Two children lack focus. She's incapable. recruit him for Satan. Someone has become cynical. One revolt. Contested title, Kingdom of Moose Jaws. My wife Hamden has offered to travel to the Tang Empire on a mission to bring glory to the Sheikdom of Kuvir. Please, my lord, she says, let a humble servant strengthen your relations with the Emperor of the Tang Empire. Would a brilliant effort go with my blessing? I think Valad Hormozd is more suitable for the journey. Jamala would make a better impression of us. I'll send Jamala, the demon child. There we go. I'll send her. And I'm just going to see who is going to... My heir is the Sheik of Shaban. And he has had his title stripped from him as well. So that would be the Sheikdom of Shaban. He has claims on the Abbasid Empire, Moose Jaws, Emirate of Tabaristan, and his heir, my kinsman. Your horse has always struck you as being a dependable sort of quality. You feel sorely lacking in your counselors. Time to shake things up a bit. You appoint him as your new Grand Vizier. Glitterhoof, I appoint thee as Grand Vizier of the realm. And we'll end it there. My empire is in tatters. I do have a genius as a great grand heir, or an heir two times over. My titles have been stripped from me, except for the being Sheikdom of Tabriz. And Glitterhoof will survive without a personal set of armor. And we'll leave it there, and this could be the end of the Zoroastrian Restoration, as the Caliph has decided otherwise. I perhaps made a mistake in not converting to Sunni Islam when I had a chance, and then the intrigue focus did not give me the opportunity to falsely confess the faith. It only gave me the option to falsely confess the Zoroastrian religion instead of my liege's religion of Sunni, so I did not get that chance. But I did make it to the height of Lucifer's own, and that may be the... And I did sire a child with the inbred trait. So that is the last achievement of this achievement run. I think I got about 4 minor achievements, and I'll play another episode and see if it is, 18th of December, I sired a child that has the inbred trait, so I did make an achievement, keeping it in the family. If you enjoyed this video, consider hitting the subscribe button and the little bell, and you'll receive notification of my other videos in the future. Have a good day.